Hi everyone, welcome back to Code Android. In this video, we are going to see about WebView. If we want to load website directly inside our application, we need to use WebView. For example, e-commerce app needs to show tracking details. That time, they need to show client website. To demonstrate this, I am creating a new application with default configuration. I am naming the application as Simple Browser. If the application which you are creating needs internet access, then add internet permission in android-manifest.xml. Open activity_main.xml. Change the root layout to linear layout. Adding orientation as vertical. Removing all the views of the root. Adding a relative layout with width as match parent, height as wrap content. This will be the navigation bar for our browser. Inside, we need three buttons for back, forward, and go. So, add a button with width as 48 dp and height as wrap content. Setting text as less than symbol. We can't specify less than or greater than symbols directly. So, create string resource by selecting extract string resource, naming it as back, click on OK. You can find this string resource under res values string.xml. You can see the less than symbol is converted to character data. Assigning ID for the button as btn go back. We need three buttons, so select the button code and press Ctrl D to duplicate selected code. Changing the button IDs to btn go forward and btn go. Change the forward text as greater than symbol, setting btn go text as go. Align the forward button after back button using to end of attribute. We need an edit text to enter URL, so add an edit text with width as match parent and height as wrap content. Assigning an ID for the edit text, aligning the edit text after forward button using toEndOf attribute. Using align parent end attribute, placing go button to the right side of the layout. Aligning the edit text before go button using to start of attribute. Adding a web view below relative layout with width as match parent and height as match parent. Assigning ID for the web view. Adding max line as 1 for the URL edit text. Otherwise, it might hide the web view itself if the URL length increases. Open mainactivity.kt. Setting onClick listener for btn go. On click of this, we need to load the URL which is entered on edt URL. To load URL, we need to use load URL method. I am appending https with edit URL text because without this, website will not load. Setting onClick listener for btn go back. If webview.canGoBack, then calling GoBack on WebView, otherwise showing a toast. To create toast, we need context. Using this context, showing the toast as no history available. Duplicate this, change btn-goBack to btn-goForward. If canGoForward, call goForward. Let's launch the application. The website is opening in default browser. Because in Android, if URL is detected, by default it will open the browser. To avoid this, we need to pass our own WebView client. Class MyWebView client. Extends WebView client. Inside, we need to override should override URL loading method. Calling load URL on the WebView object getting the URL from the request. Using null check, if the view is not null, calling load URL. If the request is not null, then getting the URL. We are getting an error because this method with this parameter is available from API level 21. To solve this, add requires API so that this method will be executed on Lollipop or later devices only. Now we need to return true. To support lower API levels, we need to override should override URL loading method with webview and URL as parameter. Similarly, we need to call load URL on webview object and return true. To avoid warning, we need to use @suppress for my webview client. Now we need to set this client for the webview. Now launch the application. Open google.com. Clicking on the image, the new page is loading on our webview itself. Also, clicking on back button, we are able to go back. Again pressing the back button showing toast because we don't have any page. Similarly, next button also working fine. That's all for this tutorial guys. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. If you have any doubt, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Also, if you need any tutorial on Android, let me know in the comment section. I will try to do that. Hope you like it. I will see you on my next video. Have a good day.